In this class, we are going to discuss an example problem related to multiplexers. So here in this problem, we will discuss how to design a specific functionality by using multiplexer. So see the problem here, implement f is equal to summation of min terms they given and using multiplexer. So which multiplexer, by using which multiplexer we need to implement this functionality they didn't given, we can take as our requirement. So here how we will implement this type of functionalities means when min terms are given means nothing but combinations. So here, so first of all we need to define truth table. Truth table is initiation for any implementation. So to get the truth table, definitely we require some inputs and outputs. How many inputs we need to take, that is important, and our output is obviously our functionality. So we are defining the truth table for our required functionality, that's why the output is obviously for functionality. The inputs are dependent upon the functionality given. So in previous classes we are having functionality of equation with ABC like that. So here how we are going to get an idea about input variables means according to this min terms. So see here, what is the maximum value of min term here is 7. 7 min terms are there means actually min terms we are having from 0 to n minus 1. So here that means 2 power for a n variable function, for a n variable function we are having 2 power n min terms or max terms. So here the value of maximum value of n, how much you need to take to satisfy this min term range. So definitely if you are having 7 min terms, so that is you can take from 0 to 7, that means 8 min terms you are having. So how much value you need to take to satisfy this 2 power n must be is equivalent to 8. So if you take n, so n is equal to 3, then you are having 2 cube min terms, that is 8 min terms. That 8 min terms are from 0 to 7. You may have any min term in the range of 0 to 7. 0 and you can skip 1, 2. Here you can see 0 is not there, but the maximum range is 7. For example, if you are having min terms like 1, 2, 3 only, you are not having 6, 7, then definitely no need to take 2 cube, 2 square is enough, because so 2 square is 4, that is you are having 0 to 4 values as your min term, 0 to 3 values as your min terms, totally 4 min terms. So you need to take n is equal to 2 only, that n represent number of input variables. Now in this case definitely 3 onwards, after 3, greater than 3 if you are having min terms means to satisfy that. So your number of variables must be, number of input variables must be 3. So here I am labeling that input variables as A, B and C. I am taking that input variables as A, B, C and my output function I am taking here as F. So now I am going to draw my truth table for required functionality here. So if 3 input variables are there, how many combinations will come means obviously 3 combinations we will get. That 3 combinations are 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. So just 0, 1, 2, 3. So 4, 5, 6 and 7. So I taken the all binary combinations of this input variables. Now we are going to define this function. So here we are not given with any equation. If they given any equation, then according to that equation we are taking the variables as input. Now they directly given where we are the function is having 1, where we are having that function. So the function is taking 1, so that means the value at 0, 0, 1 must be 1, means this is 1 min term, min term representing 1, this is value representing min term 1. So 2, the value representing min term 2 is 0, 1, 0, just 2 binary you are going to take. So here also you are having 1, so at 3 you are having 1 and at 6 you are having 1, at 7 you are having 1, remaining places you are not having 1, at 4, 5 you are not having, and at 0 you are not having. So all these are zeros. So just I am closing this truth table. So now by using this truth table, if you are want to design this functionality using multiplexer, just you need to place your functionality at the input of marks, and your input variables must be taken at selection lines. This is the process. So here I am going to take 8 by 1 marks. So 8 by 1 marks, as you are having 8 bits at output, 8 combinations at output, definitely 8 by 1 marks, you must take 8 by 1 marks. So here this 8 by 1 marks is having 8 inputs and 3 selection lines. So here we can have 3 selection lines. So because every marks is having 2 power n inputs and n selection lines, for this 8 by 1 marks, if inputs are 8, definitely, so if we relate that with 2 power n, n value, that means selection lines values may be 3. So 8 by 1 marks must have 3 selection lines. Now see here, whatever functionality, output functionality is there, that I am presenting here 0, 1, 1, 1 and 0, 0, 1, 1. This is my output functionality. So now the selection lines I am taking like ABC. This is the process, that's it. So if anyone give you any functionality that you need to design with multiplexer, then you just take input variables and output as functionality. You just take the functionality value according to the input variable combination, take a marks relevant to this number of steps you are having. For example, here you can see 8 combinations. So I take in 8 by 1 marks. So for example, if you are having, if you can do this is in 4 combinations, then I can take 4 by 1 marks. So now I take in 8 by 1 marks, just present this output at input side and present your input variables at selection lines. So for example, so what MUX is going to do means, according to the selection lines, it's going to take the input value to the output. So for example, your MUX selection line input is 010, it's going to take second port value to the output. Second port value means this is taken at 0th port, first port, second port, like that you are having 7 ports. So when selection line value is equivalent to 2, your MUX is transferring this data, this multiplexer transferring second port data to output. That means 1 is coming to output. This is like a digital switch. We can say this is a digital switch. So this is switching the inputs to output based on the selection lines. So here for example, if you are having 0, 1, 1, so that means 3, third port value will come to output. You can observe here, when you are having 2, you are getting 1. So when you are having 3, you are again getting 1, like that. So you design the functionality by using 8 by 1 marks. For example, if they given you how to design this functionality by using 4 by 1 multiplexer. Yes, we can do if there is a relation or if we can omit any variable, input variable, then we can do this. So you can clearly observe here, in this 8 combinations, so I am segregating as 4 combinations. So see here, so this is this this thing is F is equal to, you are having, so here you are having 0 and here you are having 1. So here you can observe AB is 00 and AB is 01 and AB is 10, AB is 11 here. So these you can consider as mandatory output inputs, and when AB is equal to 00, C may be either 0 or 1. In condition of A is equal to 01, so C may be either 0 or 1. In the condition of 10 of AB, C may be either 0 or 1. In every case, you can observe C as don't care. C is going like 0 or 1. So here you can observe, in this case, I am just writing like this. So this output I am taking like C. In the case of AB equal to 0, your output is equivalent to C. So you can see here 01 is there, 01 is there. So I am just taking the relation of third variable to the output. So here In case of 01, without taking the reference of C, the output is equivalent to 1. So now here you can observe, in the case of 10, AB is equal to 10. So without taking the reference of C, so this is equivalent to 0. So in this case, that means in the case of AB is equal to 11, without taking reference of C, so your function value is equivalent to 1. So in the first case, when A is equal to 0, B equal to 0 only, so it's taking reference of C, the function is equivalent to C. So generally, now we reduced 4 states into 8 states into 4 states. So same thing we are doing here. So now I am taking 4 by 1 marks with 4 input lines with 2 selection lines. So now my 4 inputs may be this output now. Now what is the output means? C101 is the output. So now what are the input means? C is don't care here and AB is only the inputs. AB is only the inputs means 00 condition, 01 condition, 10 condition, 11 condition, only 4 conditions. So here my selection lines may be AB and here the inputs, I already told you while discussing this, whatever output functionality is there, that you need to take as input of multiplexer. So here C101, this will come to output according to selection lines. That means if AB is equivalent to 00 condition, what will come to output? 0th port will come to output. If AB equal to 00, so 0th port, that means C will come. You can see when AB equal to 00, you are getting C. That C may be either 0 or 1. That will come to output. So for example, if AB is equal to 01, so here first port value will come, that means 1 will come to output. So that means see here, when AB equal to 01, so without knowing C, so definitely you are getting 1 at the output. So in the same way, we are getting this functionality by using 4 by 1 marks also. If they given 8 by 1 marks, or if they given 4 by 1 marks, you can design same functionality by using both maxes.